Good morning, students. I hope you are having an A+ week. Today we are going to learn our first lesson, the magic porridge pot. What's the title of the lesson? The magic porridge pot. It's an interesting story about a magic pot. Do you know what magical power the pot has? Let's see. Once upon a time, there was a little girl called Poppy. P-O-P-P-Y. What's the name of the little girl? Yes, Poppy. Poppy lived with her mother in a small house. Did she live in a big house? No. It's a small house. And one bright morning, she was walking in a small forest. There she met an old lady. The old granny, that is the old lady, was traveling to her home from the market. And the old granny was carrying 4 heavy bags. How many bags she had? Yes, 4. Now look at the text. The magic porridge pot. Once upon a time, there was a girl called Poppy. She lived with her mother in a cottage at the edge of the woods. One sunny morning, she was walking in the woods when she met an old lady. The old lady was carrying 4 heavy bags home from the market. Who was walking in the woods? Yes, the little girl, Poppy. What time of the day was it? Yes, it was a sunny day, that is, morning. Then where did Poppy live? Yes, in a cottage. Let me help you, said the little girl Poppy to the old granny. The little girl said, I could help you, granny. I could carry the heavy bags for you. So the old lady was surprised by hearing the words of the little girl. What a kind girl. What a kind words. So the old granny was surprised by the words of the little girl Poppy. Let me help you with those heavy bags, said Poppy. How kind you are, said the old lady. So how did the girl help the old lady? Yes, Poppy helped the old lady carry the bag home. Poppy helped the old lady. She helped her by carrying the heavy bag. So the old lady gave her a little porridge pot.
What's the meaning of porridge? It's a type of soft, thick, and white food. What do you eat when you are sick? Yes, your mother will give you porridge, right? So porridge is a healthy food. It gives us energy and makes us feel bright and active. And the old lady said that the pot was not an ordinary one. It was a special pot. And the old lady showed her how to use the magic pot. Poppy helped the old lady carry the bag home. The old lady gave her a little porridge pot. She told Poppy that it was a special pot and showed her how it worked. So in order to make work the special pot, the little girl Poppy should say a magical word. What's the magical word? Cook, little pot, cook. This is the magical word. Say the word. Cook, little pot, cook, and the pot will give you delicious, that is tasty, hot, creamy porridge. So after having the porridge, the little girl should say again, stop, little pot, stop. What's the magical word? Stop, little pot, stop. If it not stop by saying, stop, little pot, stop, it would never stop. Carry on cooking. So this was the magical pot given to the girl Poppy. Once you have eaten enough, say, stop, little pot, stop, or it will carry on cooking. Poppy thanked the old lady. What could the pot do? Yes, the pot could give tasty porridge. Then who gave Poppy the pot? Yes, the old lady. Holding the pot tightly, the girl ran back to her home in order to show the magic pot to her family member. So she was very happy. Clutching the pot, she ran home as fast as her legs would carry her. She excitedly showed her mother what the pot could do. Why did Poppy run home? Yes, she wanted to show it to her mother. So after a few days later, the girl was visiting her grandmother, whose home was another side of the small forest. The little girl Poppy reached the home and kept the pot on the shelf, and Poppy went out. A few days later, Poppy was visiting her grandma on the other side of the wood. She was not home when her mother began to feel hungry. She took the little porridge pot down from the shelf and put it on the table. So her mother felt hungry and took the pot from the shelf and put it on the table. And she said, "Cook, little pot, cook." So why did Poppy go to the other side of the wood? Yes, in order to visit her grandma. Immediately, the pot was full of tasty hot porridge. Poppy's mother ate stomachful and she felt asleep. In her rocking chair. But she forgot to say, "Stop." So the pot cooked and cooked and cooked. And there was porridge everywhere. "Cook, little pot, cook," she said. Soon the pot was filled up delicious, hot, creamy porridge. Poppy's mother ate a large bowlful and then she fell asleep in her rocking chair. She had forgotten to tell the pot to stop cooking. So the pot cooked and cooked and cooked until there was porridge everywhere. The porridge overflowed out of the pot and spread out the dough and filled all over the town. The porridge poured out of the pot onto the floor, through the rooms, down the stairs, out of the door, into the lanes, and all over the town. Poppy returned home and found the porridge poured everywhere. And she shouted, "Stop, little pot, stop!" At last, the little pot stopped. There was porridge everywhere. So people around the home took the porridge and used it for breakfast, lunch, tea, and dinner. When Poppy came back, she shouted, "Stop, little pot, stop!" At last, the little pot stopped. There was so much porridge that everyone had to eat it for breakfast, lunch, tea, and dinner. So it's not good to waste the food, right? So what's the meaning of breakfast, lunch, tea, and dinner? Yes, breakfast is the first meal of the day, that is morning meal. Then lunch, midday meal, that is noon meal, noontime meal. Then tea, evening snack, and dinner, evening meal. So why did Poppy's mother put the porridge pot on the table? Yes, in order to eat the porridge. Then where did Poppy's mother fall asleep? Yes, in her rocking chair. Now look at the picture and do the exercise. Don't write anything in your classwork note. Write down the answers in a rough paper and send it through WhatsApp, because it's from your workbook, so you can write when you get your workbook. This is the assignment for this week. Now match the columns to complete the sentences. The old lady's bags were H-E-A-V-Y, heavy. Poppy was kind, K-I-N-D, kind. The porridge was delicious, D-E-L-I-C-I-O-U-S. The porridge pot was little, L-I-T-T-L-E. The weather on the day Poppy met the old lady was sunny, S-U-N-N-Y.
Be a kind kid like this little Poppy. Hope you have understood the concept. Happy learning. Meet you in the next class with another beautiful concept. Until, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.